when a man comes to realize where I am supposed to be and where have I am landed up my life with. And when he repents and returns back to God, the mercy of God comes upon man and he rebuilds his life. The Lord is going to speak to us. Hello, my dear son, my dear daughter, who are you? Why did I create you? Where are you supposed to be? And where are you now? Abraham, who knew that this girl is carrying my child, he chased her away. So this woman did not know what to do. To the eyes of the world, she is a fallen woman. To the physical body, she is a sickly woman. She is a pregnant woman. She is a helpless woman. To the human society, she is a fallen woman. She is a servant girl. She has no money, no one to go. So she thought the only way is, I can go and commit suicide. The people who want to commit suicide, those who have no courage, they will begin to walk in the desert. If they walk at 10 o'clock to the desert, 2 hours, that is the end. Afterwards, you can't return back. In the desert, there will be hot waves, and the sand waves will be moving around, and in the heat, you have to fall down and die. And this woman has walked. Now is the time. She's a pregnant woman, and her eyes are going around. She was almost fallen, dying. When she is in a helpless state, she began to cry. What have I become my life? What have I done with my life? What have I become of? Whenever we come to our senses, who am I? Where I am supposed to be? Where am I? What have I made of my life? That is the time God comes. God began to call upon her. Hagar! Hagar! She began to look around. In this desert, I am a useless woman. To the world, I am a fallen woman. I am a sinful woman. I am a pregnant woman. I am a servant. I have no money. I have nobody to speak for me. Who is that calling me? Look around. The Lord never leaves us. He called her again. Hagar, I am your God of Abraham. Go back to your mistress. I will take care of you. Her mind might have told her, if you go back to your mistress, she will hit you once again. She said, no. My God is telling me to go back. Because I have seen the one who has seen me. She said, Lord, your name is Yahweh El Roi, the one who has seen me. I have seen the one who has seen me. If you come to realize the truth that I see the one who sees me, who knows everything of me. She went back home, and as God promised, he rebuilt her life. He rebuilt the child in her womb. Today, where are you? God is asking you, in this retreat, go back to your inner self. What happened to the love you had for the Lord? Once upon a time, Jesus, Jesus, you are crying, getting up early morning, you are crying upon the Lord. You are empowered by the Lord. You are enriched by the Lord. What happened to that joy? Where have you lost that joy? And where have you landed up your life to today? God is calling you back. Today's gospel we read, God chose Peter as a great servant. He said, Peter, I will build my church on you. You are a rock. And no power of darkness will touch you. What a great anointing. But the same Peter, he did not know where he is going to. He is not aware where his mind is leading to. He just followed his feelings. A man of joy became a man of depression. Whenever you are depressed, know very clearly the enemy is at your door. You should know where you are supposed to be. Yes. We read in the Bible, during the time of Jacob and Leah, his wife, there was a wonderful daughter, Dinal her name. And the Lord's servant Jacob told her, learn discipline and live in your home. She said, no, I will go all over the world and I will see. She went away and the man raped her and threw her into the street. God chose a great servant called Gehazi to be a servant of a prophet called Elisha to make him another great prophet. But that man's eyes fell on the riches. A man called Naaman, he came, he was a leper. He came to Elisha. Elisha healed him and blessed him. And when Naaman gave gold and silver, the prophet said, I don't need to follow the Lord. What is needed, my God has given to me enough. I don't want to stretch out to that which is not needed for me to follow him. Maybe for some others needed, not for me. I don't need your gold. Go back home peaceful. Know the living God who has done great things for you. Be grateful to God and live a holy life. Go back. But the servant of Elisha who heard, he was feeling so bad. If my master would have received, I would have enjoyed all this wonderful clothes, gold and silver. So he ran behind Naaman and said, lie. My master is getting a guess. He needs this gold. He needs this clothes. He got it back. Elisha asked him, where are you supposed to be? And where have you landed up your life with? You are supposed to be in the protection of the Lord, in the provision of the Lord. For a servant of God, God will provide you. Why have you stretched out your hand in front of a leper whom God healed? You landed up in where you are not supposed to go, so his leprosy will become yours. A great man, he was called to become a great prophet. He became a leper. Yes, Peter was supposed to be such a wonderful servant of God. When the Lord is caught and kept in Caiaphas' home, he went and sat with the woman, people who were crucifying Jesus. He did not know where he is supposed to go. He landed up in the wrong place where he denied the master. And that one of the women caught hold of his upper garment. Peter, an apostle, having lost his garment, he ran naked. Is it needed? If you do not remember, stay where you are supposed to, the enemy will take you to shame, to a place where you will lose yourself. Where are you? What happened to the love? The original love you had for me. Where have you lost it? You are mine. You are my child. You are supposed to hide yourself in me. You are trying to hide me from me. Return to me. You will be rebuilt. You are not meant to be destroyed. You are not a problem. Why do you cry day and night? You who are supposed to celebrate life, you who are supposed to be a blessing, a guiding light, Why all kinds of people have entered into your life? All kinds of habits have entered into your life? What have changed your life? What is the glory for which I called you? Why that glory disappeared? Return to me and rebuild by me. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you, for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.